Gaga's rhetoric is persuasive because she so intimately involves her fans in her lyrics. She says she lives for the applause, which means that her famous persona cannot survive without her fans. She says in the chorus, "Give me the thing that I love, I'll turn the lights out. Put your hands together, make them touch." Here she also promises to entertain them as long as they, her fans, continue to make her famous by listening to her music and going to her shows. Because this whole idea can be rhetorically pretty egocentric, Lady Gaga's rhetorical discourse emphasizes her love for her fans, or monsters, versus her love for fandom itself. Her lyrics state, "If only fame had an IV, baby, could I bear being away from you? I found the vein, put it in here." Here, her fans are analogous to a lovable and addicting drug. Unfortunately, her fans come with the side effect of fame. However, since she cannot bear being away from her fans, she must get high, for lack of a better explanation, from the music industry. She has used this theme before in Bad Romance, where her lyrics and video metaphorically represent her as being a sex slave to the music industry. We see this reinforced again through her references to drugs and sex in relation to famedom, with her images and lyrics. Gaga uses four resources to assist her goal of persuasion. First of all, she makes an argument that art and academia are worth being popular. She does this repeatedly with her emphasis of art through the images we see in her video and by referencing it in her lyrics, as she does with reading too, but I will get to that later. Not to mention, she titled her album Art Pop. She also appeals to her listeners' emotions by use of the word geeks, a stigma that has unfortunately been attached to reading in general. Here she appeals directly to a passion that is underrepresented in society by sticking up for the act of reading. The fact that she arranges her messages in music is rhetorical in itself. especially when we think of rhetoric and power. Music is the location and arrangement for her messages, where she can speak out and perhaps influence her audience despite existing power structures. She effectively uses her symbols of music and appearance as a source of power, where she also uses this power, or these symbols, to define values like art and academia. Some groups have a greater opportunity to be heard than others, which sheds light on the rhetorical implications of her arranging herself and her messages in pop music versus heavy metal, for instance. Gaga uses her aesthetics to develop her themes and messages. She also uses memorable and shocking fashion, hair, and makeup that is controversial in mainstream society. Rhetorically, this shock factor assists her in gaining attention from her viewers and listeners. Gaga has created a new genre of music called art pop, where instead of pop culture being a focus of art, art is a focus of pop culture. Art has become a main characteristic in her aesthetics, message, lyrics, videos, and live performances. She makes a reference to Jeff Koons, a contemporary artist whom she collaborated with in the creation of her album cover, Art Pop. Metaphorically, she says she used to be the artist, but now she is the art. This can be interpreted to mean that she constructed her own persona meaningfully and artfully. Here, the repeated symbolic association gives her rhetoric the psychological power over her listeners, intending us to construct our own identities more meaningfully, which is also a call for authenticity and uniqueness. That is why I included images of myself doing yoga, so I could follow suit and represent my own artistically constructed area of my identity. Hopefully the intent of me climbing up a ladder of books is clear in regards to the implication of Gaga's lyrics, but if not, let me explain. The language we associate with the act of reading, like geeks, is unhealthy. Right now, a common stereotype for women is to be ditzy, while a lot of media enacts this uneducated or illiterate quality as being cute, there are rhetorical implications for that too. It classifies women as unintelligent, adding to the theory in women's studies of the glass ceiling, where women are inhibited by stereotypes that prevent them from succeeding professionally. Combined with progressive and positive associations of literacy and success, we can see how this area of the text also functions feministically. Lady Gaga makes reading sound cool, which means that somewhere in the world an adolescent female's idol just made reading cool, in contrast with the pop star of my childhood, Britney Spears, who embodied the stereotype of the dumb blonde, who was also just an extension of male objectification. Rhetoric often plays a critical role in determining what we accept as true, right, or probable. Gaga knows that her rhetoric is response-inviting, so she immediately calls attention to her critics while calling on her fans to drown out the possible negative response with their applause. She tries to expand our stereotypes and assumptions of women by stepping outside of social norms, like representing herself in a number of ways that are not what we expect. For instance, she emphasizes personal ornamentation, whatever that may look like, which is interesting because Gaga has received negative feedback from media and viewers as being plain and masculine in natural appearance. I think it is rhetorical in itself because she didn't hide that from society. Whether her physical beauty is plain or masculine, her personal ornamentation is always artistic in a fashionable sense, where her rhetoric embraces art as beauty, essentially a created beauty or beauty of the mind. However, her supposed ugly and sexual aesthetics aren't her only means of controversy. Her use of a trigger word, like coons, make us re-examine ourselves and our role in society. Whether it was on purpose or not, her use of the word triggered negative reactions because of the stigma it carries with it about African Americans. While controversial, it also invites her audience to attach a new meaning to the word and to look past the history of racism. Lady Gaga's rhetoric persuades viewers and listeners to keep her famous because she will continue to entertain them. However, she uses her fame rhetorically to ignite social activism and change. She does this by emphasizing art and academia in an attempt to redistribute the value associated with them. She uses symbols repeatedly to gain psychological power in an attempt to set an example that art and academia should be emphasized in popular culture. Though controversial, her images and diction re-examine popular beliefs of gender and race by expanding the way their role functions in her music. Lady Gaga is ultimately an effective retort because her aesthetics are shocking and memorable, while her lyrics persuade by eliciting responsibility in her fans to keep her famous, and by the way that she arranges her messages in the widely listened to form of pop music.